So this is the plan. Myself and my good buddy Lawson, this dude right here, gonna be jumping on a float plane in about an hour from Anchorage, Alaska to Bristol Bay. From there, we get off the float plane. We meet our buddy Scott Rose, who is the dude that put me on my first peacock bass in Florida. He's a long way from home, and so are we. First time in Alaska, first time chasing after these fish that live in these waters. Let's hit it. I'll see you guys in the air.
Welcome to Alaska. This is what it's all about.
That's a trout and a half, folks. That is a trout and a half.
Oh my God.
Whoa, it's gusting out here in the tundra. We just landed to the spot just over that little ridge right there is our it's the zone. It's the rainbow trout hole. But just look at this view. Holy shit, like, this is incredible, man. Rods, 5 weight, 7 weight, bag full of camera gear and some tripods, water, and the most important tool of the trip, bear grenade, or as you guys may know it as,
yeah,
bear spray. Let's get rigged up. Smell it.
You'll get used to it pretty quick.
Let's fucking get it.
Let's go air punch, buddy.
Yeah.
I wish you guys could smell what we're smelling right now. This river is soaked, just caked in dead sammies. But that's not what we're after. If we were after salmon, we'd be totally screwed right now because everything is just dead. We are after bows, and more rainbows.
It's super shallow right now. The water's been dropping.
That rock go into my foot.
Yeah. Water's been dropping every day for weeks now.
Leading the whole way, and you want line behind it.
Line behind it, going
so upstream.
Whistle current. Upstream, okay.
The indicator's free drifting.
And I got
once
you.
That goes down, you set up over your shoulder downstream.
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 Oh, I'm on again. Oh, there he goes. I just pulled off.
Still there.
No, he's not. He's gone, Scott. I'm pretty sure he's gone.
Still there.
No, he's not. He's gone. Are you fucking kidding me? Just smoked me. Those f***ed, bro. Okay, so I thought trout were miserable. Growing up as a kid, my dad would take me to like a little trout pond, all stock trout in Illinois.
Yeah.
So like when you told me we were gonna catch like rainbow trout, I was like, oh, okay, cool. Like on the fly, that'd be neat.
You see that what fish, I'm talking about now,
that
right?
Was like a steelhead. That thing wrecked my ass.
Steelhead size.
Yeah.
Come down here.
Okay, cool. Holy shit. That was intense. There's a grizzly just chilling right there.
Yeah.
Right next to the fishing spot.
Nice.
Hold on. First catch of the trip, probably the most miserable catch. I went in my backhand, and what is that? Oh, nice. Caught a sockeye. You gonna measure that one? Smallest fish of the day. Nothing like catching a dead fish in your backhand. Scott's like, yup. Never in my life have I ever been this close to a bear and felt this semi-comfortable. I'm not gonna say I feel comfortable, but I definitely feel somewhat comfortable. Hey, bud, where are the rainbows at? You're pretty dialed on the salmon. This is the carnage. This is what happens when you make babies, you die. So kids, don't make bait. No, I'm just kidding, that's only salmon. Came all this way to lay some eggs and you perished. Wild, but again, that's how we're after. The real prize is bows, in case I haven't said that 1,000 times already.
There.
That's a fish. That's a fish, good one. I'm letting him go. I'm hooked up, oh God.
Big fish.
Oh God, I saw him, yeah. Yeah, woo! That was crazy. She's going, she's going, she's going.
They're walking down.
Okay. Nothing like a fish that brings you to your reel immediately. Just like, before you can even blink. This might be the one, guys. This might be the first fish I catch in Alaska. There he goes. There he goes, there he goes, there he goes, there he goes, dude.
Lack of backing is a problem.
Yeah. We've got one issue. There's always issues, right? Never in my videos is it ever gonna go smoothly. The one issue I've got right now is this reel is not really loaded with too much backing. I don't ever fish for many fish species that put me into my backing. And this is kind of a situation where I can't just sit and watch this fish go. I'm gonna have to kind of walk with this dude. The other thing is this is a pretty big rainbow. Like this is a pretty quality one. If we can land this, this will be easily my biggest rainbow ever. I underestimated these fish, like 100%. And telling me, oh my God, it's a good one. Just keeping pressure, not too much. Nice healthy balance between pressure and finesse. I'm a noob, don't listen to me. But these are all things that Scott was teaching me just a few moments ago before I hooked into this beast. This is happening right now. Look at that rod bend, guys. Mother Nature's just beating me down right now. I've got a beautiful rainbow on the other end and the rain just comes in like this. Hopefully, I'm praying to God I get this fish in. You never know, you could fight a fish. Doesn't matter what species it is for like 20 minutes and then all of a sudden it just pops off.
Higher up on it.
Wow, that's a fish. Scott's going in for the grab.
Welcome to Alaska, dude.
Are you serious?
Oh,
yes, yes, look at that trout. This is my biggest rainbow, first fish in Alaska. Holy nut. Scott wasn't kidding when he contacted me a few months ago saying like these fish are no joke. Big old male rainbow. And here's the crazy thing. I don't know if you noticed this yet, dude. Which he's already got a hook. Yeah, there's another hook in this fish. Which means we're gonna help him out a little bit here. This fish has owned someone else before me. I'm surprised that wasn't the one that got owned. At least I got owned, but we succeeded.
Oh my God.
What? Actually?
This fish is 27.
27. It's gonna girth for sure. 27 by
14 and a half.
Talk about a first fish, man. This is badass, about as badass as it gets. Oh, before I can even finish talking, you're gone. See you later. He's right by your shoe.
Get a little scratch, a little back scratch on him. Break.
He thinks you're a piece of structure.
He's using my fat ass to break the curve.
All right, stay right there. Hopefully they post up on you here in a few minutes. If that doesn't get you fired up, I don't know what doesn't. Put her there. That
Woo,
is,
man.
That is extra
I'm
amazing.
I'm stoked, and it was your fish.
Let's get some more. This is Alaska, baby. Just upriver, so he's
right
there.
Here,
I see
it.
Yep. Wow, okay.
Got him.
That was crazy. That was crazy. Oh shit. We got problems. Drag was super loose. We're good, we're good, we're good, we're good. I think it was because I don't know if this reel is like or something.
I don't think it's that bad.
Okay. All right, doubled up. Second fish for me. We got Mr. Brown Bear right here, Lawson with a fish. I've got a fish. Actually, Bear's got a fish too. How's your fish, Bear? Hey, Bear. Ooh, this one's not too bad. Oh, just pulled. That could have been a double. It's giving her a little too much heat. Pulled off. That's gonna happen a lot this trip. Big fish time, big fish time, big fish time. Oh, I'm on, I'm on. I literally was pulling up for another freaking cast and I got hooked up. Okay. All right. Oh, he's gone. He's just gone. Tail walking like a tarpon. Hell yeah, that was gnarly. There he goes, 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 there he goes. Oh, look at that. Little hen, female bow. This one's a female. The way you can tell between a female and a male is by looking at their face. This guy right here has got, or I guess this girl right here has got just a blunt nose as a dead piece of salmon swims past. I don't know if you guys can see that. See how this fish has got kind of a blunt, soft nose, a soft head. Lower jaw is really soft and rounded. Like, that's how you can tell it's a hen. And the males have that big kipe, and that kipe is that kind of gnarly looking lower and upper jaw where it's like mangled and such. Usually I have a tendency to start small and then work my way up. But today I'm starting up and then working my way down. Pretty fish, I don't know if you guys can see her. She's pretty, pretty gorgeous. And there she goes, back to the current. Thank you.
Oh, there she is. There she is. There she is. That was cool. The free. Go eat salmon eggs. Scooter.
All right, John, walk down with yours.
And just like that, I'm back on the board. I was catching a lot of small fish. Wasn't doing too good there, but I feel the heat coming again. Really wide fish. Gorgeous. Lawson's in the background messing with his. We're gonna put this guy back. Wow, it takes like no effort to revive these things. It's like one push and they're gone. So much power, even after a big fight like that. Money.
In case you guys were wondering, I'm not using a long lens. We are literally that close.
Well, there you have it. That's the king of the river. You don't mess with these guys. You share the river with them and you also share the fish. They're here eating the salmon. We're here catching the trout. It's not much of a competition here because we're going after two different fish, but I imagine if we were trying to steal the salmon away from them, they wouldn't be too happy. And he's just off. I am someone who's deathly afraid of bears, grizzlies, and black bears. I think after being on this river for like, what, 5-6 hours, I've kind of squashed that fear. You just kind of have to, right? Unless you don't catch any fish if you don't squash that fear. Multiple times a day where we were, what was the closest we got? Like 20 yards, maybe 15?
Yeah, 20 yards.
Yeah. Yeah, I could have like tossed my streamer at a bear's nose today. Pretty crazy to think. It's pretty close.
He kind of gave a puff at us there.
Uber! Uber for John! I think that was our Uber.
Wow.
So, we're loading everything up right now. And gonna get back to the lodge, hang out at the sauna, have a few Tito's lemonades, and just chill. Kick our feet up and reminisce on all the big, beautiful trout we caught today. There's the airplane.
Yo, what up? Well, we're back at the lodge now. I just want to do a quick jump cut for you guys. We're finished. We completed the first day and we survived in Alaska. It's official. We're pioneers. we made it happen. Today was a lot of fun. It was a learning experience. It was kind of a moment for Lawson and I to kind of get into the groove. The first day of most of these big trips is always about learning, observing, and then eventually finding a place in which you can kind of, you know, work your way into the trip. My viewpoint of rainbow trout has dramatically changed from the time I woke up this morning until the current time right now. Like, I don't know. I mean, obviously I have appreciation towards trout, rainbow trout especially, but it's just hard to fathom that a fish like that, you know, like a 22 inch, 24 inch, 27 inch rainbow trout could do that much to your arm, your line, your rod, and your hook. If any of you guys have never done this before, I urge you guys to get on this. Like, this is incredible. This is insane. The people at Royal Wolf Lodge are like the best. They're super chill. Been hanging around the owners a lot as of recent. Chris, the guy that flew us to and from the spot, is the owner, and he's a really awesome guy. He's a really stand-up dude and has taken the time to kind of teach us and also give us some intel of this place and what it means to fish in the tundra. This is huge. This is like the equivalent of fishing the Amazon, only it's the other end of the earth. But I just want to kind of give a wrap up for today's video. Everything is good. We are safe. I smell like fish. I'm soggy. It was really wet today, but I'm happy. And I'm content, and I'm so glad I got to share this experience with you guys. If you guys ever want to do a trip like this, I'll leave Royal Wolf Lodge's link in the description below. You guys can replicate this trip. You can stay in this exact room, catch those exact fish. Well, maybe not exact fish, but you can catch rainbows. I'll leave their website below, all their contact information. You guys can book a trip here. It's epic, it's dope. I would highly recommend it. This is coming from a guy that's fished all around the world. This is the place. This is really sick. So that's it. I'm signing out. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video. I really appreciate it. I'm going to bed. I gotta get recharged for tomorrow's fishing mission here in Alaska, but that's it. Love y'all. As always, folks, keep fishing. Never stop.